Hey guys, it's me, John. Ella and I are out doing a couple jobs today, and naturally we had to stop here in Crichton and stop by the bakery outlet and get some good bread. Yeah, they got some really good deals in here. You can get like 5 loaves of bread for like 15 cents or something like that. But we just finished up a job in Tolmanville. And now we're going to Stico Automotives. We gotta go and inspect those guys. A lot of fun. Wish you were here. All right, we're at the Super 8 Motel. We're doing another inspection. Me, I got the dirty job. I got the measuring wheel. So right now we just measured across the front. That's 58 feet. I just walked 58 feet, man. I'm exhausted. I'm almost sweating. All right. Anyhow, I'm going to do the side here and in the back, and we'll be good. So now I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to let you see exactly how hard the work I have to do here. I've got to go from this point. Let me turn it around and show you. From this point here all the way down there. I'm not sure if I can make it. I'm gonna try. I've got my GPS signal on my phone, so if anything happens, I need assistance. Use my phone to track me down. All right, so here we go. That's 30 feet already. I'm getting lightheaded. It's 50 feet. I'm not sure about this. Is there some sort of record for how far you can walk and measure at the same time? Anyhow, 100 feet. We just broke 100 feet, so we still got a lot to go. Oh, the break in the building. I don't know. That is 125 feet at the break. And 4 feet through. So we're starting to break the second break at 130. So here we go. All right. I'm getting dizzy now. Not sure. Here we go. Okay, yeah. I think I got, so I'm over the wall. I'm good. Okay, there's the end right there. 205, 212, 13, 14. I'm gonna make it. All right. Ooh, there's a nasty washcloth here. That's 244. It clicked right here on the edge. You believe it? I made that. I walked that distance. Right.
I've done my walk around, measured everything.
Here we are. Super 8. Moffett Road. Some of you recognize this. There's the interstate right there. There's the old Tarpon Lounge over there. There's a lot of businesses. Volvo trucks. But I've done my part. Now, she needs to hustle up and get her stuff done. She's got to go inside, do a couple rooms. Check the smoke alarms, fire detectors, security doors, air conditioning, things of that nature, to make sure they pass all the entrance standards. Me, I get,
look at that.
I actually broke a sweat.
You know that?
I think it's kind of cool today. I think it's like in the lower 80s today, which is kind of nice. It's not that cloudy. It's not that hot. But we're pushing about 10:30 in the morning. So we go from here to Pico, do some cars or their buildings. So if anybody wants to see us, that's where we'll be. That walk around got me real messed up. I thought I was gonna pass out. She had to go and measure a couple of rooms, and now she's going in and she's doing a little follow-up work on with the owner of the hotel. I think his name is Mr. Patel. I'm not sure. Is that right? Yeah, Patel, yeah. Anyhow, oh, but they had some cool stuff in there. It's a map, downtown Mobile. See it? Ooh, gives me all the cool places to go to and everything. And it's also on the back, gives you, in case you aren't familiar with the area, this is a map of Mobile. This is Baldwin County over here, and this is Mobile. And if I'm not mistaken, let's see where we are. Is that right? Yeah. No, I'm sorry. I did that backwards. This is Mobile, and that's Baldwin County. We should be, let me see, right about there, just off of 65 and Moffett Road. But anyhow, it's pretty cool. They had a bunch of these in there. You can just tear it off and look at the map. So if I ever get lost, I can use this as a directional map. This is for you kids. This is called the old school GPS. And they had these things on the end of each street. They, on metal poles, they actually had the name of the street on the pole. So when you drove to it, you could actually look at it, refer to your map, and go, hey, that's where I'm at. All right. Well, I see she just hop skipped out. And she's taking pictures of the exterior of the building. So in just a few moments, we are going to be heading out. Well, turns out I have to get a roof shot of the exterior of the roof, so I'm gonna have to borrow that. But I have this handy dandy telescoping pole, and on the end there's a quick release that screws on, and basically what it does, it goes onto the top and it has a spring-loaded attachment that I can put my cell phone on and do a self-timer on the photo. All right, I did my exterior shots and still waiting for her to come out. She's doing a couple of follow-up questions with the owner-operator of the Super 8 Motel. And I think I misquoted earlier when we were at the bread shop. We were supposed to go to Skiko from there. We actually stopped here and then going to Skiko. And then, for those of you who don't know, Skiko is like a huge auto discount store. They sell cars to anyone. If you get, you got a heartbeat, they'll sell you a car. You don't mind 30% interest on your loan, that's where you want to go. But other than that, I think once we do this, we're done for the day. And go home and load the photos, finish up the paperwork, and sit back and wait for the check. All right, you just gotta wait for it.
That's just the little vacant building.
Another little stop we had to do on the way. It's very simple. It's the old Smokey Joe's place here on Azalea, just off Azalea. They tore the building down. You know, it's like they're doing construction here, and we got to get some overall shots of the progress of the construction. I'll show you what it looks like here. Let me flip you around here. And there you go. And that is what we have to do. So, no, it's tough, man. You guys, you just don't understand what we have to do out here on the road. This is hard, hard work. What's hard is getting into it. Once you're into it, then it's easy. There are some that kind of, you know, worry me sometimes, like neighborhoods, and you know, sometimes she'll go out on her own and do jobs, and I'm not quite sure where she's at. It might be a bad neighborhood. It might not be. I don't know. But some people in these days and age, they just, they're not real happy about having somebody come in there and
ask them about different parts of their property and want to take photos and measurements and things. So it's it gets a little worrisome. Yeah, I worry about her. But she's out there and she's doing her thing with the camera. She's taking some pictures. So as soon as we finish here, we're going to head over to, again, Mexico. So we'll catch you guys from Mexico. Hard working Americans. Let me show you what I mean, hard working Americans. These guys, it's like 142 degrees outside right now. I'm sitting in an air conditioning car, and here's these guys. You know, that's why they get paid big dollars. And I get paid, you know, mine are not big, but they're not small. Well, yeah, they are. My dollars are small. Yeah, bless her heart, they're working. And it's 10:44, and I think if I read the temperature right, it says 118 degrees inside here where the air conditioner's running. So it's got to be real hot out there. But anyhow, you know, these guys, they work hard. They're good at what they do. They earn their money. So there we go.
Ma'am, I've got an appointment for inspection today with Mr. Kabir, and it was supposed to be about 10-ish. We really didn't put a time, but I told him morning. I had to stop up here at the broken iPhone store. I got some camera issues that he's fixing. So let him know as soon as I finish with my camera, fixing my camera, I'll be on that way. Thank you. Bye-bye. That's perfect. I mean, either way, even this one, you know, because it goes into right at the foot of Lakeside.
But no, now come on, you start short.
Just go this way. No. Why you want to do that and be a butthead?
I'm not butthead. I'm going this way. I've got my mind made up, and that's what I'm doing.
Well, then you gotta fight the traffic up around when that's right there at Lakeside.
Just make a left turn.
Funny. Why would you want to make a left turn?
I didn't say I wanted to. It says you can't make a left turn.
You wouldn't want to make a left turn.
I never said I was making a left turn. I just read the sign. No left turn. I am fine. Go your way.
Whatever. You trying to sound like me.
No, I picked that up for your daughter. Hang around long enough to pick it up. You need to go by there one day.
Where?
You teach bank.
We can do that after you leave here. I mean, we got a Skiko left.
Skiko.
We got them left.
I feel bad. We just keep putting them on. Are we going straight?
Mm-hmm. Keep going straight.
Can't see the corners if there's cops.
All right. You want to go straight?
Straight?
Mm-hmm.
Are you sure?
Mm-hmm. All right.
Okay.
This is turning.
I know that. You sure we can't go turn?
I mean, you can, but this comes out at the foot.
We are going to have to.
Darn.
See, I told you we should have took the service way.
Told you we should have gotten the turning lane.
We
straight.
Are in the turning lane. No, that's the gold people.
No. Oh, they don't like you parking and other stuff. He laughed that day. That day that I was in here, he says, I don't care what they say. They don't own this parking lot.
Whatever. All right, go get them.
I'm gonna ask him how much they charge to put a battery in this thing one day. I love you.
I love you too.
You're not gonna come in?
Oh, no. I wanna be there when the bullets start flying. All right, we actually had to do a little side trip here because Evelyn uses her little her iPhone to take most of the pictures. She's got an iPhone 4S and it's got the HD camera on it. She uses that now instead of the old Nikon camera. It's kind of a one shot, does everything. Anyhow, we came over here and we're at the broken iPhone store. I don't know if you guys are aware, we actually have one of those here in Mobile. It's called the broken iPhone. And she's sitting in there and her complaining about the phone. The screen started flickering, going, you know, up and down. And then 15 minutes later, the whole screen just turned black. Everything, you could hear everything. She's getting her messages, getting all the other stuff. But there was no visual thing. So what had happened, the little cable in there had come unplugged. So the next day, it was late in the evening, so the next day I brought it over here and the guy took it apart real quick at the front desk right there, and teeny tiny little screws, and he snapped that cable back in there and we were good to go. But today, he started doing it again, so here we go.
I want to use the business card.
Oh, he's charging you?
No. He's going to put a battery, a $50 battery in there for $20, since he's already got it open.
In the phone?
Yeah, so I can have a fresh battery. You want a fresh battery?
I don't need a fresh battery. Did you ever give my wallet back?
You freaked me out, you know?
No, well, so now, apparently, as you just heard, since he's got the back of the phone open, she's going to go ahead and install a bigger battery in there. So she, you know, man. See, I put mine on a dock at the end of the night, and it starts charging right away, and it charges extremely fast, but it sits there, and the only time I ever use it is when I'm doing stuff like this. But anyhow, we brought it back over here. It was on the way. We were right there at the construction, so we came over here, and he's snapping the cable back on there, hopefully get it back in place right this time where it's not falling out, and they're going to exchange the battery, $20, and put a bigger battery in there. So anyhow, this guy's on Lakeside Drive, just as you come off of Government Boulevard, instead of heading toward the ball field, you turn right, heading west, and then you get off, there's a sign right there, it says get off to Lakeside Drive, you turn off there onto the service road, and that takes you right there. We're in the, it's a little plaza right here, you can't miss it. If you look to the left, it says broken iPhone, it's a 3700E. The broken iPhone. His hours are Monday through Saturday, 9 to 5. Phone number, 251-289-9675.
I'm going to measure lengthwise.
Lots of air conditioning units here. Gotta keep them customers happy. Alright. Length is 61 feet. So we're actually here at the Skiko. I don't think we're going to be doing that a lot over there. I think it's going to be doing... Not doing that? Yeah? Doing that? We're here at the Skiko. We're going to head over to building 2. As you can see, a lot of those salesmen, like, they were happy to see us pull up. They were waving. They saved the parking space for us. Got out, ignored them, walked right by them, went straight into the office, told them what we were there for. Come out, started measuring and taking pictures and everything, and they're like, oh, this sucks. Whoa. I guess they thought they were gonna make a big sale.
so I didn't get that check. Not today, boys. All right, so we're at the beginning of building two. And drop my measurement taker. We're here live at Go Automotives, where you too can have an automobile of your choice for only 33.33% interest rate. Yes, sir. We finance any and everybody. Look at that cloud. Look at that sky. It's like a bunny rabbit right there.
Oh yeah, she's all working hard up there. Look at her.
She goes where no man dares to go. And then no man dares to ask her why or tell her to leave. That would be a bad mistake. I mean, my work's done here. I'm hot. I'm sweaty. Shoot, I may be ready for an air conditioning vehicle. What do you choose from here? We got these trucks. Come on out here and buy yourself a truck. We got trucks. You need trucks? We got them. We got Chevys. We got Toyotas. Yo, they got Dodge. Huh. They got Jeeps. I don't see any Fords. There you know. All right, so we're gonna put the measuring stick up. Ah, there's a Ford right there in front of us. One lone Ford Ranger. All right, so anyhow, that's how much hard that was. A couple hundred dollars paycheck. Once we submit this and get it all done. Sad part is we get paid whether they let us do it or not. If they don't, then it's their problem. They have to contact their insurance company and explain to them why they wouldn't allow us to access to their site to do our inspection. So they pay us for that. And then once they establish that we can come in there and we must come in there, then we come back out and we get paid again. Well, that's the outside part of it. Now, the paperwork and the uploading, downloading, initial drafts and then redrafts, they have to be submitted, resubmitted sometimes. Sometimes they take them on the first try, sometimes they don't, but either way, we're okay. Once she's done over there, then she'll go in and ask them a few questions. You know, things like how many employees do you have, how many full-time, how many part-time. Do you have security cameras? Do you have smoke alarms, fire alarms? What kind of suppression, fire suppression do you have? Do you have any alarms, security cameras? I don't know if I said that or not. Do you have patrols that go through the area? If you do, are they armed? Are they not armed? Actually, in some cases, they ask us for the payroll, too. They'll ask how much they made last year profit or total, and then how much payroll they had, so they'll have to give that information out. So there's a lot of stuff that's involved in here. Each one of them's different. No two are exactly the same, which kind of makes it a little difficult, because if it was, we could just cookie cut each one of them and send them back in. But we're in our eighth year as PhotoDell Inspections. I say we, I mean, we started it. She did for about 2 years, and then about the remaining 6 years has been mostly her doing all this physical stuff. You too can have a vape
Bye, guys. Hope you enjoyed driving along with us today. It's been fun. It's been unique. We've had a little unusual stops, but nothing out of the ordinary on a typical day. And we have finished. It is now, she'll finish up probably in the next 15 to 20 minutes, and it's 12:30 in the afternoon. So we'll be back home probably around 1:15. So that's our day. We started out around 10 o'clock in the morning. No, I'm sorry. We started out about 8 o'clock this morning. So, all right, guys. Enjoy your day. Enjoy this. And if there's more we can, if you have any questions or anything, feel free to ask. And I will definitely try my best to put it either in video form or in text form to answer your questions. All right, take care.